person in line. Yo, you had a good heart. Block motherfucker.
Yeah,
block motherfucker.
Like, you know, like, I'm not gonna do it. I don't actually ever participate, mm-hmm. but I don't wanna get to the point that one day be like, hey, did you see my message? What message? Chris, I have your number. I tried to call you and said you wanna go through. So then I called you with, you know, somebody else's phone. And, you know, you answer, so what's going on, bro? And I'm going to be like...
God damn. Yo, have you heard the Nicki Minaj album?
No.
At all?
Just the one song you sent me, wow. And I was like, wow.
Did you hear she has, like, a Queen radio thing, though? And she gets, she has, like, her own, like, radio...
Station?
Kind of, yeah, I guess, like, I don't know if it's a radio station, but I think it's on iTunes. So, you know, iTunes has, like, stations and stuff like that? I think she's doing something there.
Or like Beach One?
Type thing. I think it's something like that. I haven't heard it at all. But apparently she has, you know how Charlamagne has like Donkey of the Day?
Yeah.
She has the same kind of things. She has Cocksucker of the Day. She has like, yeah, like.
She made like a female version of the, yo, freaking Joe Budden's gonna be on Spotify.
I heard about
that. He made it.
Like he has a partnership with them. What's that about?
Because you know his podcast has been blowing up?
Yeah.
Blowing
like,
up.
Big, yeah.
So now, I guess, you know, because we were watching on YouTube and whatnot, and SoundCloud.
Yeah.
But now he got a partnership with Spotify, so you can get it on Spotify. So for people who have Spotify, you don't have to, you know, use any of the streams.
Yeah.
So you stream it through there, so obviously he wins, he profits.
Oh, of course.
Spotify profits because they're going to get streams.
Yeah, they get more.
So, Joe Budden made it. And that might be having, they're going to have special episodes just for Spotify.
Just for
Spotify. So, like, you won't be able to watch some episodes on any other platform.
He has really good, he has the pull up, I don't know if
the kitchen one, right?
Yeah, he does have a lot of them. He has a few. But those are actually really good.
Like, I haven't seen them, but I follow them on Twitter, and I see that it's blowing up, like, it's mad blowing up. And then when I saw, like, the posted, like, pictures of the New York poster of, like, starting September something, Joe Budden.
Damn, that's crazy, man.
Cause
his podcast is dope, though. Like, some of the reviews that he does and stuff, it's pretty funny.
No, and he includes a lot of different things. Like, he talks about culture.
Yeah,
and,
culture, just in general. Yeah. I mean, that's what's up. Because now, like, a lot of people, you know, it's a different world. Like, a lot of people are doing... So many different things. We have so much direct-to-consumer things nowadays. Let's just say, like, Nicki Minaj was mad at Travis Scott.
Because he used the clothing line, the merch, to get numbers, right?
So she's saying basically that, she's number two, right? So she's saying that, the only reason he's number one is because he, like you said, you know, he was using the merch or whatever. And every time you buy any merch, you get a copy of the album. So it counts. It's a sale. It counts towards sales. So, you know, she did, like, I think it was, like, 168,000, like, the first week or something like that.
But then she commented, because DJ Academics was like, she did 168,000, which is a really good number.
It is.
But still ended up falling short to Travis Astroworld, right? And that's what DJ Academics put. And she tweeted, she's like, she Instagram replied. She was like, numbers ain't done yet. Like,
Sorry,
you better check, because we're not done with the week yet.
I think Nicki Minaj fell off, though, by now, to be honest with you.
I think the fact that she made 168,000, like, that's huge for her, in my opinion. Maybe because I just done them. I never really followed her, let's be honest.
Okay, look, there's the thing. So Nicki, you know, Nicki's been, like, the queen of hip-hop, right?
Yeah, Cardi came in.
Come on. Cardi did 250,000 like her first week. I think her thing went platinum.
You know what thing about Cardi? Is a Cardi? Yeah, Cardi's hip hop, but Cardi was able to merge people from all genres.
No, this is what I think. So this is what I think about Cardi. Though. I think the reason why Cardi's so likable is because Cardi's her.
Ratchet.
Like that, and think about it, like, you know, mind you, Nicki Minaj has always been like this character. I feel like until like recently, right? Like, you know, she's always played like these weird fucking weird wigs and right. She's always played this character, and Cardi is just like. Cardi already had a fan base from the get-go, without music, without nothing, just being herself, right, just being fucking funny or whatever, and then, you know, when she finally did music, like you said, yeah, she definitely did, like, a category of things. I just think that, at this point, like, just Cardi just took
over. Yeah, and I'm telling you, like, part of it is, like, she was able to get handles and, like, business and, like, to really tap into her, like, her full culture.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, because, like, for example, that song with Jay and Bad Bunny, bro. Everybody loves that song because everybody loves Bad Bunny.
Yeah.
If you're Hispanic, if you're Hispanic, like you love J Balvin.
Yeah.
If you're Hispanic,
for sure.
And if no matter who you are, if you're in Florida or Miami
J Balvin his music is really good.
But I'm saying, but like worldwide, J Balvin is, you know, big time. But like Bad Bunny is like the hype now.
Right.
And then, you know, you get those two guys, plus you get yourself, you know, who she got her own skill, because she killed it with, you know, all the stuff she's done. But also, you know, the fact that you also got the hype with Migos. Like, and the fact that you got in songs with, like, you know, now you're in Maroon 5. Now, you know, she's with people from different genres. That's helping her a lot, because Maroon 5 is one of the biggest pop music bands there is, you know.
They're pop or rock?
I don't know if it's pop or rock. Let's Google it.
Yeah, Google it.
Maroon 5, I don't know what the genre is considered, but, you know, she was with them. She made songs with a bunch of these girls. Like, what is it, with Kehlani or Kehlani?
Yeah, with SZA.
She's with a bunch of different people. So she merged into different areas.
You know, like, her fight, like, and I don't really want to say her fight. It's just that, like, people are saying, like, oh, she doesn't even write her own, like, lyrics. She doesn't, you know, whatever.
American pop rock. So we're both
American pop rock?
So
it's like pop and rock? Okay. I mean, Maroon 5, from at least that song I've heard, is like really good. Like that's
Maroon 5 is killing.
It's really good. But I don't know, man. I just think that, like, is she just like I was watching an interview and I'm thinking, like, yo, realistically speaking, look at all the albums that came out. At least like the big ones, right? I don't think she could really match up to. And I don't know the numbers, so I can't really talk on all of them, right?
Nicki or Cardi?
Nicki. Nicki can't really match up with a lot of the people that came out. Like, Ye had a whole month for himself, basically, right? He had Pusha T. He had himself. He had himself and Kid Cudi. He had, who was it? Well, before Tiana Taylor, somebody else.
Nas.
Yeah. And he had Tiana Taylor. So he had an entire month, basically. Tiana Taylor came like a week or so later. And then, you know, obviously, nobody's competing with Drake. At this level, you know, Drake has been. You know, that's another thing. How the fuck, dude, has Drake managed to stay so fucking good?
Like, I'm telling you, the thing is like, people see music as like a thing that you listen to, right? That's how people see it. But Drake and all these people that are like really, really successful, they have seen music as a part of culture that can allow them to tap into different areas. You know, like, think about that song, you know, Never Stop, right?
Non-stop.
Uh-huh. Right? He's talking about it. He's like, I get 40 the owl told to brand it for me.
Yeah.
Right? He's talking about different things that he did. So he was able to use music as a platform to build the brand that is Drake.
Right.
Like, you see OVO, you don't think, OVO stands for, you know, a Canadian label. You think it stands for Drake.
Yeah.
Right? You see Virginia Black, it stands for Drake.
Yeah.
You hear his dad's voice, you know, it stands for Drake.
Yeah.
Right? You hear Degrassi now. Even people who never watched Degrassi, you think it stands for Drake.
Because
he built the brand, and hip-hop was a platform for him. But now, Drake is too big for hip-hop.
Like,
think about it. Nobody calls Drake just a rapper.
No, he's not just a rapper.
Nobody says, Drake is a rapper. Even what's his name when he was trying him? Pusha T didn't say he was a rapper. Pusha said he's a pop star.
Yeah.
Which is too big for hip-hop.
This is the thing. The thing is that, you know, how do you jump on every song and kill the song?
I don't know if he kills the song.
No. What song has Drake been on that's not hot?
That's the difference, though, but that's not killing the song.
No.
That's what I'm telling you.
Killed the song, bro.
No. Because
the song.
To me, there's two different things, and that's what I want to get at. It's like Drake has built the brand. So you see Drake as a feature, or you see a song by Drake, you have to. Check it out.
Yeah.
Have to. But that doesn't mean he kills the song.
Yeah.
No. Because there's songs that Drake leaves things to be desired. There's songs that he hops on and you're like, he murked some songs. But Drake has created, I think this is what makes him so successful. He created the Drake sound. Like, there is a specific genre of music called Drake to me. To me, like that, you know, like the soft
like
hip hop, driving, kind of like R&B mix
OVO
in there.
I think OVO, like, you know,
like Party Next Door, you know,
Tour
Lanez, he created the Drake sound.
Dude, but anything Drake is on, he's body.
I don't know, is that,
yeah.
But is that your definition of body? You mean like, yo, it's gonna sell. That's what you mean, right? For me, I talk about like, yo, lyricism, there's times that he's like, leads to desire.
Okay.
That's what I mean when like, yo, when people say, yo, this guy bodied a track, they mean lyrically, he murked it. There's times that Drake does it, there's times that he does not.
I think this we need to discuss. I think we're beyond past that in hip-hop already. I think that we're beyond the
lyrics.
No,
but that's what I'm saying.
We're beyond
like
those
things. If you say blow up, yeah, every song Drake does, everything Drake touches is going to blow up.
It's going to blow up, turns to gold.
But when you say body, my context is lyricism, because it's still, you know, but when people talk about hip-hop, they're like, like when people say, yo, J. Cole bodied that. J. Cole lyricism, right?
Yeah.
Oh, Kendrick is in that song? Lyrics.
I get it.
Body. But now blow up For sure. Everything Drake touches, everything you put Drake in, you know, that freaking thing he dropped in England.
The freestyle was fire.
Everybody, within 20 minutes of uploading it, it was going viral.
It was already like a thing. Yeah, I get where you're coming from. Like, it's just, I don't know, it's just crazy to me how long of a run he's had.
Yeah, bro.
Look, I was watching an interview with Kanye West. I think the interview dude was like back in like, I don't even know, 2013 or something like that. And Kanye was saying like, yo, you know, right now this is the sound of Drake. You know, Drake's a wave right now. And that was such a while back.
Yeah, but Kanye has always been ahead of
and then. Dude, that's so crazy to me how Drake is still stay so relevant. Like, it's such a... Okay, everyone, look at this, bro. Lil Wayne, at one point, was considered one of the best rap...
Well, Lil Wayne had his season, too. Lil Wayne had years.
That's what I'm saying. Like Nicki Minaj had her time, where Nicki was,
yeah,
like,
but Nicki,
on
no,
everything.
No, no, no. I think...
Nicki
I, no,
was
no, no,
on
no, no,
everything.
No, 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 but she's not at the level of Drake, Lil Wayne. You know, the way I remember it...
Female artists,
I mean not female male. I mean, like, success, the top, top, the top. I would say Drake, right? Like, by seasons.
You know, statistically, she is one of the best.
Yeah.
Period.
No, but I'm talking about, like in hip-hop, like, heads, not just sales and stuff. I mean, general, right? I would say this is a Drake season, right?
Mm-hmm. Before that... Season. I don't think we're in a Drake season.
What do you think we
we're
are?
Past a season, dude.
No,
we've
but I mean,
been with Drake
by
for
season,
years.
I mean years. Like, this has been, like, the moment... You know how every...
Dude.
Every, like, for example, look.
Dude.
90s. Tupac. N.W.A. Biggie. Right, the early 90s,
okay,
early 90s,
okay.
Right, early 90s,
uh-huh.
Right. Then you go to, you know, Diddy, you go to all these dudes, Snoop, blah, 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 right? Later 90s, because they were still alive at that time.
Uh-huh.
Right, 2000s, Eminem. Early 90s, I mean, late 90s, 2000s, probably Eminem. Probably like the biggest. Then I would say probably who, Kanye, Lil Wayne?
No. I think you're a little bit off on
that. Who?
Because you're missing, okay, look. You're missing a lot of big artists.
I'm not trying to main everybody. I'm trying to the one. Because, you know, every moment has
one. But I want to remind you about something, though. All of these guys, like you said, they had a season. Like, they had, like a thing. It's like, okay, like at one point, Justin Bieber was one of the biggest things ever, right? At one point.
But,
right? That was, like, a middle school.
I'm talking about just success. I'm talking about, like, owning... That industry, like, everybody has, like,
yeah, but that's what we're talking about. Justin Bieber is one of the biggest.
No, right now, but he's still successful, like, crazy.
He is, but that's the thing, though. We have so many artists that are successful, but Drake is not. He's beyond success.
Yeah, that's what that's what I mean by season.
Every,
like, this is his moment. Like the last couple of years have been his moment.
No, more than last couple. Dude, for the last 10 years, it's been Drake.
2008. What did he drop in 2008? Never.
Bro,
So Far Gone.
Bro, Drake's been.
Over and So Far Gone, take those
I have no idea, to be honest.
Over and So Far Gone.
I feel like Drake's been around for too long, dude. Like,
he has
like,
been around.
I personally found out about Drake, I think around 9th to 10th grade. Right?
Which been how long ago? That, like 2000 years.
This
bro.
Was, that was what, 2010? Around 2010? I was in 9th grade about 2010.
Yeah,
like, that's
I mean,
found out about Drake.
Like,
that's when Drake was coming up. Like,
yeah,
bro,
like,
he wasn't coming up. Time.
I was saying So Far Gone.
Like,
that probably has to be like So Far Gone, right? Around that. Like,
look at Spotify. Go to Spotify.
No, I'm just looking at the Discovery.
Okay.
I can see the time. Drake, where's Drake? Let's see. Albums. Rise of Empires released in 2014. No, we are Young Money, but that's Cash Money. Mixtapes. 2006, 2007. So Far Gone will be 2009. That's when I really remember, like, Drake's starting to take over.
Okay, and where the fuck are we now? We're about to be in 2019, and Drake is still. That's not a season to me. That's like, that's way, way,
well,
we're
that
way
be a,
past
that
seasons.
That would be what? A century? No, that's a century.
Bro.
That would be a decade.
Bro, that's not a season.
No, but that's what, but, no,
that's
but,
automatic
but what I mean is that when you think season, you think 4 months. That's because you think it like literally.
No. I understand what you mean by season. Like, you know, it could be a span, but bro. Because, okay.
You know, I think music
if
works in
been,
sounds.
Listen,
music works in sounds.
We've been so, Drake's been so like, it's like every year he gets better and better and better and better. Look, all right. What has Drake always been known for, right? Drake's always been known for the super sad guy rapping about girls.
Yeah, you're
driving
night.
Yeah, you're driving night kind of guy, right? That's what Drake. Yo, Drake has not let go of that sound, right? For obviously, right? When Drake bodied Meek Mill, Drake blew up even bigger.
Yeah, because nobody thought he was a savage.
Right?
Everybody
right.
thought he was just like a little
right.
soft Canadian rapper. Whatever.
When Pusher bodied him, dude, Pusher killed that. In my opinion, Pusher murdered him. Like
way more than what Drake did.
Slaughtered
way
him.
More than what Drake
and
did.
And that didn't affect Drake at all. That shit did nothing to Drake.
Is that, you know what it is?
Nothing.
Because Drake doesn't have the your regular hip-hop respect. Like, Drake's not... Like, we all grew beyond seeing Drake as hip-hop. Mm-hmm. And that's what has allowed Drake's success. Because if you just look at him on the hip-hop genre... Only in the hip hop realm, like, close-minded as like what we normally define.
He is.
No, I'm saying this. Listen to me before you say something. Right. Okay. So when that normal standard of what we most people define just your classical hip hop genre, Drake is so much bigger than that, right? If we would only see him as only hip hop, then people would be like, "Yo, his rapping skills, his lyricism doesn't match up to Kendrick, doesn't match up to J. Cole, doesn't match up to." But because Drake has a sound. It's like, yo, sure, some rapper made fun of him, but people are like, yo, Drake is killing the 12-year-old little girl, and the same thing was a 40-something-year-old dude who's still trying to rock off yo, because Drake has coverage, like, generations. That's why Drake, like, you know, Pusha murked him completely, and it still does not gonna dent what Drake has built. He built an empire.
Yeah. No, I mean, the same thing could be said for Meek Mill.
But Meek Mill's not at that level, bro.
No, but Meek Mill, you know, after Drake killed them, then what? I mean, sure, people are like, oh, damn, yo, you got murdered, whatever. But I mean, Meek Mill now is still one of the biggest. I mean, mind you, the whole Free Meek Mill thing. Beyonce.
No, but Free Meek Mill is like, that is like, you know, you bodying what we all know, which is the civil struggle of an African American man.
Of course, but
I understand what you're saying, but
it's just a bigger movement that, you know, it helped people look beyond the
whole. No. But obviously, Meek also was benefited by the fact that, you know, the Eagles took behind, you know, Dreams and Nightmares, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, because that was like the song towards the Super Bowl, and that's when they won,
right.
Started singing it out,
right.
And so it was like the whole, but like there were surges, but. Meek Mill is Philly.
Yeah.
Drake is Canadian and he's U.S. Put it in perspective, that's what I mean.
For sure.
Drake is beyond the U.S. Like, his European
Drake
tour... his European tour all sold out. Everything he does sold out.
The thing is, okay, this is the thing. This is what I'm trying to get at, right? We have all these rappers that have been, you know, the biggest, right? Jay-Z has been one of the biggest, right? Kendrick's been one of the biggest, right? J. Cole is one of the biggest. All of these rappers have been one of the biggest, right? And yet, they can get on the track and not necessarily do what Drake does. Why?
No, but what do you mean by what Drake does?
Dude, like you said, right?
Sell the song.
Anything Drake
does. Sell the song.
Anything. You know, the thing is that I feel like we're beyond that, though. Like, okay.
That's what I mean. Like, if you...
When you say... This is what sell the song is.
You and I have
sell
different appreciation
is.
Of music.
No. This is what sell the song... What's sell the song nowadays? Stream. Listening. That's what sell the song is.
No, I understand. That's what I'm saying. Like, when it comes to Drake, anything he touches is going to blow up. But when I say, yo...
Kendrick can't do that.
Kendrick's albums are all double, triple,
platinum
certified.
Yeah, but I'm saying, Kendrick jumps on a song today, he's not putting what Drake is putting up.
In what sense? Like, what do you mean
putting
up?
In numbers.
Oh, numbers, yeah, probably not.
Okay, but that... Okay.
That's what I'm asking you.
Chris,
when you
listen to this.
Look, are you talking about financially or are you talking about skill-wise? That's why I keep asking clear to me. Because to you, it's like, oh, if it's financial, it's amazing.
Okay, let's get one thing out the way.
But for me, music matters. Like, lyricism matters.
Let's get one thing out the way. The market. What does that mean?
What does that have to do with skill?
That has everything to
it
do with skill.
It doesn't have to do with skill.
Okay. If we both, right? Both of us sell the exact same product, right? Let's just say we both sell the exact same product. I sell more than you. What does that mean? What does that say about me?
That you're a better salesman?
Okay, so I'm a better salesman. And we both sell the exact same product. And I'm a better salesman than you, I'm better than you.
That's
yes
selling.
Or no? But we have the same product.
And what is that? But, so you're going to tell me that what Kendrick does is the same thing as what Drake does?
Well, they're both rappers. They're both in the same element as rappers. That's what they are. Lyricness, because you can't... There's a thing, you're talking about lyrics, right? And I understand...
No, I'm talking about everything. Because to you, that's what I mean. Like... If you talk about the solely the business aspect, I bet on you everything
this,
Drake
this is
does.
This is what I'm trying to get.
But to me, it's like, look, to me,
you're missing an important
for
concept
example,
of market, though. You're missing an important concept.
No, but
market.
You're missing an important concept of music. Music has to be more than a market.
Okay, this is where you're missing at. This is what I'm saying. You're not understanding what the market is. People are the market. People are the ones that choose what they like, what they don't like. So numbers, you're looking at numbers like it's a financial thing. It's not a financial thing. Numbers, we're not talking about numbers as in, oh, you sold 100 million, whatever. We're looking at numbers as in how many people are listening to you. Right? You know how Spotify Drake's number one in the world, right?
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
Okay, what number is Kendrick?
Like,
that's what I'm trying to get at. That. Okay, to you, in your opinion, because look, music is relative, right? Music is different. To you, the best rapper in the world could be Kendrick Lamar. And for somebody else, the best rapper in the world could be Rakim.
I understand what you're saying. But so, when you say, like, I take things personal when you say, like, oh, Kendrick cannot get on a track and do what Drake is doing. That's why I need you to clear to me what you mean what he is doing. What do you mean by what he's doing?
Drake is on a track today and that track blows up.
Yeah, exactly.
Kendrick is on a track today, that track's not blowing up like that.
It definitely is.
It's not.
It definitely is.
Drake got a Lil Baby's track, yes indeed. That track blew up in one day.
Of course.
Kendrick is on a track and Lil Baby right now, that track's not blowing up like that.
Well, it depends what Kendrick says. People are going to check it out anyways just to check what he says.
Yeah, they'll check it out, but they're not going to check it out to the level. Okay, look, let me give you a perfect example. I have a 15-year-old little girl right over here, right? My little sister, right? If Drake drops a new song right now, she knows about it, and she's going to bump that song with all her friends.
Yeah, but if this
Kendrick drops a song right now, she's not going to give a fuck about it.
But if J. Cole drops a song, she's going to do the same thing as Kendrick.
Yeah, exactly. She's going to do the same thing, for sure. Exactly. I agree with you.
But that's what I'm saying.
But I
want to
remind you that J. Cole and Drake were rising stars at the exact same time, doing damn near the same thing. It's just that I want you to realize that J. Cole could have the exact same success that Drake had. The thing is that J. Cole disconnected from all of this, you know, superficial shit that you have in the industry. That's the background of it. So that's exactly what J. Cole didn't. I feel like J. Cole could be way more successful than he is. J. Cole's not on social media like that. Drake has an entire marketing team behind his social media. Drake posts a picture.
That's different. When you talk to me about Drake, the brand, I completely agree with everything you say. When you talk about it to me, like, and you say, yo, if they get on a track and... When you say, the way you say it, this is what I'm thinking. Let me clarify my head so you can understand. When you say, oh, if they're both getting a track.
You think that Kendrick is lyrically better than Drake?
When you say, like, oh, they got a track, they can't do what he.
But people don't care about that. That's what I'm trying to get to you. Like, people.
The general consumer.
They care about good music. That's what I'm trying to get at. Look, Kendrick Lamar is an exceptional artist, right? There is no taking away from his lyricism. I understand that. But I also want you to understand that Kendrick Lamar cannot put up the numbers.
Exactly. I've said that, though. But why cannot he put up the numbers? Drake has made himself a brand that you must have.
But we're talking music. We're talking about music here. It's different. No. Yo, bad music is bad music. Let's get one thing.
Drake has some bad songs, but you're still gonna see those
Kendrick
songs.
Kendrick has a bad song.
Yeah, but you're still gonna see Drake's songs. This is what I'm trying to get at. It's people. That's why I don't say it's a brand, because Drake has some bad songs. They still end up in the Billboard 100.
What bad song would that be?
Let's see what song that, at least in my opinion, I think it's bad. Let's look at the album.
That's different though. You said a bad song.
But that's the same thing when you say Kendrick has a bad song. It's like, what song Kendrick has that
I don't listen to Kendrick as much like that. I think Kendrick's an exceptional artist.
No, but you said Kendrick has a bad song. I don't think Kendrick has a bad song.
I'm pretty sure.
And when you said about J. Cole, it's right. J. Cole could have been.
Music and lyrics is very different though. Music is everything. Like I told you, you can have I'll give you a perfect example. Find Your Love by Drake. In my opinion, that song blew up. That song was a big, I'll never find your love, whatever. That song blew up big time, right? People were loving that song. I thought that song was trash. I think Kanye West produced a beat, by the way. I don't know what the fuck Kanye was thinking.
I thought it was good.
He gave him a fucking heart. In my opinion, from what I've seen from Kanye giving beats and stuff like that, that beat was so off track. That shit sucked. In my opinion, right? Mm-hmm. That's just my opinion. That song charted. It did its thing. In my opinion, that song was trash. I can't listen to that song. I personally like music I can bump to. I like the flow. I like the beat. The lyrics are cool. But when I'm in the car and I'm bumping, my mind's thinking about shit, but I'm also bumping about shit. Like, I need something that I can catch a vibe to. I don't necessarily need for you to hit me with a deep-ass story. And look, one of my favorite songs from Kendrick Lamar, Money Trees. When I hear the beat of that song, the frequency of the beat where his flow does something to me that I just gotta, like, turn the hell up. It just does something to me. You get me? So, I'm not taking anything away from Kendrick. I'm just saying, Drake is such... I feel like you said, Drake is a brand. But it's like, it's one thing to be a brand. Jay-Z is a brand, right? Jay-Z has Rock Nation and stuff like that. Yeah, all that gear. Jay-Z is huge. To rappers, Jay-Z is like their Warren Buffett. You get me? So, Jay-Z is a big brand. But every song Jay-Z drops on is not going to do what Drake does.
Oh, yeah.
But that's what I'm trying to get at. No, he's considered one of the
greatest. That's what I mean in the sense of brand, is because Drake is such an appealing brand to most generations. Right? Like, Jay-Z is revered, respected as a businessman, as an entrepreneur. But when it comes to rap, Jay-Z has a specific group that still looks to Jay-Z as a rapper, right? Mm-hmm. Which is like the old hip-hop heads.
Yeah. For sure.
But Drake, that's what I'm saying, like, Drake for me is, like, I don't ever consider Drake a rapper. I just think Drake is too big to be just rapper. Because, like, when I see Drake is competing not with, Nicki Minaj and a hip-hop album. Drake is competing with freaking Maroon 5. Drake's competing with Coldplay. He's competing with artists from different genres that he has he's competing in a different, like, for example, this new album, it's a double album. It's considered part R&B, part rap, hip-hop.
Yeah.
So he both markets. He would be number one in the billboards.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I mean with Drake. I don't ever say like, oh, Drake is the rapper. No, Drake is one of those dudes that I just call him an artist. Because what he does is gonna sell, but I wouldn't put him in a group.
Even Drake, lyrically, there's a thing. I feel like, it's like for you, right? Talking about Kendrick. For you, Kendrick, lyrically, he does something, the way he uses his words, right? He uses all these big words, right? Like, he uses oxymorons, metaphors, whatever, all this shit, right? In his lyrics, like, he's still able to keep a flow, he's still able to keep a storyline. Drake does think the probably the you know the I want to say the exact when Drake first started, his lyrics were exceptional. People like to talk shit about the whole ghostwriting stuff. We all know Drake wrote for Kanye before. Drake has written for people too, you get me? So it is this big cloud over it. But I just still don't understand, honestly, after all this time,
how he's so successful.
Like, it's not about successful, like, in the things that you've done. I understand that, like, you've taken your opportunities, you've done shit, right? Drake is worth, what, 100 million, 200 million, something like that?
Probably more than that. Well, if you venture everything, he has probably more than that.
Right. So, I don't know. But that's a lot of fucking money.
Yeah. I mean, the guy's saying he pays...
In the hip-hop space...
The guy's saying he gets paid $1 million for a feature, bro? You know, you made it.
What I'm saying. In the hip-hop space, in the music space, you're such a big person. Like, you're... Like, dude, I'm saying, man... Yo, Drake can make anything pop.
I think a big success about Drake is that he's taking a different tour or a different route than most artists take. You know, most artists are not dropping an album every 3 years. That's a guy. Drake is dropping consistently music. Think about it, right? This year he dropped 20 songs in one album.
Was it 20 songs? Was 20 songs?
Scorpion is what, like 22? 20 something like
that? I thought it was a little more. 25,
wasn't it? 25? I don't know, but it's
a lot of songs.
Let's say 20, but it's still, that's too many songs, right?
Yeah, that's a lot of songs.
Yeah. Right?
But there are...
I'm not judging the number. Yeah, yeah. I want to put the perspective of why Drake is so successful is because this dude dropped 20 songs.
Mm-hmm.
Leading up to this, he was featured in like 10 other songs.
Yeah.
Right? Before that, he drops Diplomatic Immunity, God's Plan, he drops... The one with all these girls, Without
this?
A Follow, Without a Mention, Nice for What? Like, all this is a part of the album, but he's dropping all these songs consistently.
Mm-hmm.
So Drake is keeping consumers tied to the brand. Because what happens with most consumers is this, is, alright, because nowadays it's rapid. Next week, there's somebody else is dropping something new. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, your album was fire. I listened to it. I got it to number one. But next week, I'm getting his to number one. Mm-hmm. And next week, I'm getting hers to number one. But because Drake is always in there, he's always a number one. There's no, like, Drake is constantly, he understood that we are a fast-paced taste and move on. Taste and move on. That's the thing about that you mentioned that J. Cole couldn't get on. J. Cole's like, yo, you guys don't appreciate the art.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to take my sweet time. And Drake takes, what? Since his last album took almost 3 years.
Two years, right?
And this album only had 10 songs.
Mm-hmm.
Fire, but only has 10 songs. In 3 years, and I'm not disrespecting because I appreciate the small albums, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, look at Kanye. Doesn't drop an album, drops 7 songs,
mm-hmm.
right? But these dudes, you said Kanye had a month. Drake has years. Every year he's dropping consistent. Every month you have a new Drake thing.
Yeah.
Whether it's a tour, or whether it's a song, or whether it's a feature, or whether it's a shirt, something new is coming up. So Drake has saturated the market.
Mm-hmm.
So somehow you're buying Drake. Somehow.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing, but, like, you know, so many artists have been doing that period, right? There's artists, like, for example, people talk about how Lil Wayne will probably tour forever, right? Like, I mean, yeah. hypothetically speaking, just because of the whole book and shit. But, I mean, there's artists that do that all the time. You get me? There's artists that are literally moving left and right.
Touring is definitely like what pays them. Everybody says it.
Yeah,
everybody
says it. Like, that's what makes the most
nothing
money.
Else spends like touring.
Yeah. Yeah, good. You get to sell merch. You're selling out arenas. You're getting hella
bread.
Yeah,
the profits and the tickets.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, I completely understand that. But, I mean, like, yo, it's, I don't know. I just think that in this space that we're in, it's insane to me how I could be in freaking high school as a freshman.
And still be bumping, and now you're...
Girls are loving Drake. Guys are bumping these soft-ass songs. And I'm over here at 23... And that shit is still bumping. Yeah, man, that shit is still jumping. It's still popping.
I think he just understood the market. I think he understood the market.
Yeah, cause, I mean, look, the market, the thing that people understand about the market, I don't mean what people do for you know, like,
profit.
Marketing and stuff like that. Market is the people. Like, you know, like, simple economics.
Consumerism.
Right? Yeah, like, simple economics was a market. A market is a place where buyers and sellers go to trade and
sell
goods.
Is the demand and the...
Right. Yeah. But the essential part of that is buyers and sellers.
Yeah.
Buyers and sellers, that's the whole point of the market. So, people are the market. People control the market. Yeah. Like, yo, you know, like obviously people have the power, right? Like, you know, that's why, like, big businesses, like, you know, they get scared when people are about to, like, protest against some shit like that because they know they're about to lose hella business. Yeah, everybody today decided, yeah, I'm not going to buy Coca-Cola no more.
Yeah.
Everybody in the world said, I'm not buying Coca-Cola ever again. And everything Coca-Cola owns, they don't buy. What happens to Coca-Cola?
They're
fucked.
Yeah, that's what happens with embargoes. That's why political embargoes are so critical because they mess up economies.
Right, exactly.
I understand what you're saying. And that's why, like, to me, I don't ever take anything away from Drake. Like, there's some things about Drake.
I just don't understand
like,
how the fucker is.
To
like,
me, look, to me, what,
Drake,
what,
to me,
I have
no artist.
Beef. I have no beef with Drake. What I have some beef with is with Drake followers.
What do you mean?
Like, you know, there's some people who could die by saying Drake is the best rapper alive. And I have to be like, quantify to me what you mean by great. And they'll be like, you know, like, everybody likes him. No, he's the greatest, like profit maker. That's no question.
Yeah.
Like, you know, but I wouldn't, like, and I think that that's the whole thing is like, I'm telling you, for me, a lot is always... You see, it's like, Cris, you know all his lyrics. You memorize all his lyrics. Because to me, words matter so much. And with Drake, you're right. Drake has the... He's killed us in the sense that you cannot get through a Drake song without doing this. And so, eventually, you end up memorizing, like, for example. But there's some songs that Drake are fire. For me, God's Plan, I will say, is one of the best songs, in my opinion, he's ever made.
Yeah.
Right? But, you know, dude is going to be famous till he dies, bro. And when he dies, we're going to be like, remember Drake, bro?
Yeah.
Like, we're going to be looking at this. You guys are going to be looking at Nothing Was the Same or Marvin's Room. And you're going to be looking and you're going to be like, yo, legends.
Yeah.
Because that's what he did.
All right, guys.
So, I'm sorry we took too long.
Yeah. Hey, let us know what you guys think about this whole music debate. Hopefully, pretty soon, man, you know, we get somebody who's actually, like, into the music.
That'd be dope, yeah.
Into the stuff. So we can have a more fewer conversation. I know that I'm, like, mad rookie when it comes to this music stuff anyways, but I still think it's an interesting space because it's something that we do every day. I listen to music every single day, right? In the car, in the office, wherever. So, man, that's what you guys think. You know, do you guys think Drake, why do you think Drake is still such the biggest thing right now? Let us know your opinions. Drop it down below. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for listening. Thank you guys for tuning in. You already know Spotify, iTunes. We're still not on SoundCloud because Cris is lazy as shit and he forgets. So we're gonna. I gotta get on Cris on that one.
How long have you had the computer?
Not longer than.